Hey guys, welcome back to our channel. So today we'll be talking about the spider plant. Now spider plant is one of my favorites. So let's begin with our garden story.
So we have three spider plants over here. You won't believe that the one we have over here used to be as small as this one. Actually even smaller than this one. Now, what we love about spider plants is that these do not require much effort. And if you leave these in the sun, they will still grow. And if you leave these indoors and without sunlight, but yeah, indirect sunlight, then these will still grow.
Now, another thing about these spider plants is that there are small plantlets growing out of this. So these can be cut off and made into individual spider plants of their own. The potting mix that they require is of sand, cocoa peat, compost and soil. Now these plantlets are so cute. There's a flower growing over here. See? Now these plantlets can also be grown individually. If you cut off these plantlets, and accidentally I did cut off one, so those can be grown individually.
Even though this plant is kind of drying out, it's growing a little tiny spider plant of its own. And it's so cute to watch because I think around February or September, you'll find these growing out of nowhere. Like look, one, I found one over here. Adorable. Now, these plants are going to grow throughout the year. So if you're looking for those plants which grow all around the year, then this is the one you should go for, apart from our evergreen money plants, because those are literally everywhere. So if you want to buy something different this time, you can go for the spider plant. Now while making this video, I accidentally broke one. It's kind of upsetting me, but it's okay because we can plant this again and it will probably grow into this in a month or so. Alright, now another thing that we love, this plant is just lovable. Now this plant over here, it's kind of drying out, right? But there's nothing to worry because these don't die out on you easily. So you can just remove these brown leaves and then this plant is perfect. Now, the healthiest plant that we have over here is this tiny one because it was kept inside. Earlier, it used to be sort of flat on the top and now it's getting into perfect shape. I think it's because it was kept indoor. And this plant doesn't require that much water, but yeah, around twice or thrice a week you can water these if it's winter time, or even if it's summer, you can water it on alternate days. And the one that I accidentally broke, I'll probably plant it back into our tiny one over here. It doesn't need much care. It doesn't need that much attention, so you can just drop it back into the soil and it will start growing again. Now these are great air purifiers. So if you're looking for indoor perennial plants, these are perfect, because these will grow throughout the year and keep your air clean as well. Alright, so when you see these plantlets growing out of it, this is the reason why this plant is called a spider plant. This is how it looks on the top. This is what it looks like from the side. And this is the one that was kept inside, and look how green this one is. There are also different varieties of this, in which the white part that you can see on the edge is in the middle of the leaf, and that one is pretty too. But we have this one over here and we love this one. So yeah, so this is our plant of the day that we can call, because we love this plant a lot. And by the way, these two are kept in direct sunlight. And I think it's time for us to keep this one inside because it's kind of drying out. The heat is getting harsher and harsher these days. Amazing, right? Look at all those plantlets. There are so many. And there are tiny flowers as well. I don't know if you can see. It's tiny flowers. Hope you find this video helpful and will probably get yourself a spider plant someday. Bye.